Rentals. What are some of the challenges of owning rental properties? Why do so many landlords struggle? Well, here I'm here to explain to you how I've struggled and some of the challenges that I face owning rental properties. Getting into real estate is pretty simple and easy to do. But one of the things that people don't tell you or talk enough about is some of the disadvantages of owning rental properties, some of the disadvantages of managing tenants. Not everybody is made or built to work as a landlord in real estate. And so here I want to share some of the challenges I face, and so therefore you can help avoid the same mistakes that I've made while owning real estate, because there's a lot of things that can get you in some serious trouble, legal trouble as well. So make sure you pay attention and stick around to the end of the video, because I'm going to drop some hidden gems throughout the video so to help you with your real estate career. So let's get right to it. So if you don't know who I am, my name is Keontae. I'm a local residential redeveloper in the Dallas area. I started my career out 4.5 years ago. And so a little bit about me is that one of the ways that I started out is called private money lending. So I lend my money to investors on my behalf to make a return on investment, which is how I really got started into real estate. But it started way before that. I started in construction. Started out laying granite. So if you don't know, you ever heard this thing called granite countertops? That was one of my tasks I've done at a very young age, growing up throughout the Southeast United States. And so one of the most important things I would tell anybody is knowing a little bit about construction and how the math works and how to get things done, being problem solvers, really helped me throughout my career and how I got started and also fell entrenched with real estate, because real estate, it's not a sprint, it's a marathon. So one of the most important things I can give anyone about my journey is that understanding that if it's not a great fit and if you're not going to like what you do, I recommend don't do real estate. Because real estate takes time, it takes patience, which is why I'm making this video for people like you that are interested in learning some of the challenges that I face owning rental property in my rental portfolio. And so number one, the first thing and most important is tenants. Finding the tenants, dealing with the tenants, managing them over long periods of time can be a good thing and bad thing. So one of the major challenges I've had with dealing with tenants is the screening process. Screening process consists of a plethora of people, applications. You have to go through background checks, credit checks, financial checks, making sure they have a great credit or they're credit worthy. You know, it can be a really drawn out process. So if you don't have a very robust system, it may be a little difficult for you. For me, those are one of the most challenging things that I had to deal with, was dealing with tenants. So sometimes you get lucky where you have an investment property that already has a tenant in it. But if they do not, it'll be really difficult if what your location is not correct, you don't have all your fundamentals checked off. So please make sure you subscribe to the previous video where I talk about the 11 steps to in-garden to owning real estate, specifically rental property. So step number two, the second biggest challenge I dealt with is the location. The location of the property was a really big challenge because in regard to the location can play a major factor into your rental property itself, because if it doesn't appreciate, if it doesn't stay fully rented, you know, therefore you'll start with the monthly premium or payment or mortgage that you have to pay over time. And so that was the second biggest obstacle that you have to make sure you really do your due diligence on, because it really can be the difference of you having a great rental portfolio that's always staying rented out, or you securing long-term tenants, or, you know, you just have a plethora of options to whether you may want to get rid of the property and sell it, or list a property, whatever the case may be. There are a plethora of opportunities for you if you have your rental property in a good location, good neighborhood, and also is in a stable rental market, because there's always going to be competition and also buying and selling of properties. So those are the first two that I really struggle with, just finding a location and also trying to acquire the right tenants, because it is a long process. So also hidden gem here, I'm also a registered agent in the state of Texas. So I do have a little bit of extra tools at my disposal to help me locate and have a better chance of finding a good area for properties. However, that doesn't give me no type of advantage. It just states that I have a little bit more access to certain things than the public do. So moving on to step number three, the third biggest challenge I had when dealing with property or rental management is in regard to the maintenance. So I kid you not, you would think the maintenance will be simple, just like you changing out a light bulb or you changing out, you know, a countertop or a cabinet, or you fixing a window or a screen, or the most simplest thing ever, making simple repairs to a wooden fence with a couple nails and a hammer and the job is done. I literally got charged $80 to $90 to swap out one door knob. Literally. I got charged $80. I was a fit with an $80 bill of pretty much dealing with changing out a doorknob. And so one of the key lessons here is that if you are a handyman, I recommend you. You are the key and the big winner in regard to owning your rental property. One of the reasons why I said it, because when you're dealing with other people and you can't do the maintenance yourself, it's gonna cost you a little bit of money. And so, and sometimes you may not want to spend that type of money, like, oh wow, it's a simple doorknob. But there's a lot that goes into the pricing, because you have to think about it. You have to have a contract to drive out there to and from the property. You have to have the contract to supply the materials to do the property. And you gotta pay for the work that's being performed to swap out one old doorknob, dispose that old doorknob, and install a new doorknob. So when you look into the variable things or the variable costs in regard to the maintenance, it can add up really quickly. So having the right personnel, which goes into step number four, the right personnel to complete step number three, which is the maintenance of the property, is a big winner and a big issue of mine that I've had owning a rental property. Because you're costing it up so high so fast on the smallest little things that you think are minute, but in regard to the actual maintenance and the upkeep of the property, they're gonna be some maintenance costs. So pretty much one way that I had to account for this is include that in my purchase or acquisition of that property. Because when you know your fundamentals about a property, it makes it really easy for you to manage that property moving forward. So those are the four biggest challenges I've had owning a rental property, which is why if you have the time or you don't want to invest the time, one of the biggest nuggets today, hidden gem, is to hire a property manager that can manage your asset for you. Why is that a big deal? If you don't know what a property manager is, you can simply type it in Google, but a property manager is someone that's gonna manage your asset on your behalf. So therefore, they're gonna manage the upkeep of the property. You're not gonna get these crazy calls in the middle of the night saying, hey, you know, my toilet's not working or it's not flushing, you got a plumbing issue. You will have someone to manage all of that for you on your behalf while staying in contact with you. So you can actually create another job for yourself and manage the property, or you can also create a job for someone else for a percentage of the rent between 5 to 12 to 13% of the collective rent in regards to the property as a property management fee. So therefore, dealing with the upkeep of the home, maintenance, all taken care of. So those are the challenges and also the hidden nuggets on some of the challenges I dealt with owning a rental property. So if you like this type of content, please reach out. I'm also here to help. I'm an open book. Like I said, again, I have a plethora of experience, but I'm not the expert. Like I said, again, this is going to be a journey to help and show you some of the challenges and disadvantages of finance, business, and also real estate, and also to teach you how you can get involved and make some of the simple choices I've made to help grow my real estate, finance, and business career. So if you like this type of content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the YouTube channel. I would love to talk with you, meet with you if you're in the Dallas-Fort Worth area. And I would love to connect with other like-minded agents, investors, wholesalers, or other individuals in the area that are looking to grow and also challenge themselves to be better each and every day. Because the motto is each one, teach one. So have a great day and appreciate your time. Thank you.